Greetings, friends. David Marks here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to speed up your sunset image processing routine using AI Adaptive Develop preset inside of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic. The artificial intelligence-powered presets that we are going to build today are unlike anything that you have ever seen before. If masking or develop presets are new concepts for you, then please watch some of my other in-depth tutorials on those topics before proceeding with this one. But if you're ready to learn something truly amazing today, then let's jump in and let's get started. When it comes to shooting landscapes, there is nothing better than photographing a great sunrise or sunset. Before I started recording this video, I did everything that I could to improve this image using all of Lightroom Classic's global controls here inside of the Develop module. What I have not done yet is to add any targeted changes to enhance the sky using Classic's new masking panel. Now, I've covered enhancing the sky using masks at length in some of my other videos. What I have never shown before, though, what wasn't even possible until the summer of 2022, was a way to train Lightroom Classic to help us out with this process. In a moment, we are going to build four separate masks to give the sky more light, more color, and more texture. Once we have those masks in place, then we can save all of them out as a new develop preset. The setup phase takes a little time, but please stick with me here because the payoff, once we've created an AI adaptive preset for the sky, is fantastic. To get started, I'm going to tap here to activate the Select Sky command. If you're wondering, I have the Show Overlay option turned on right now, which is why that red rubolith just appeared over top of the area that this mask is going to affect. For the first layer, I'm going to bring the dehaze control up to about plus 10. Dehaze is always a landscape photographer's friend, but a little bit of this powerful drug goes a long way. Like all drugs, dehaze has some unwanted side effects, and one of those is a noticeable increase in noise. So to counteract that problem, I'm going to add about 20 units of noise reduction into this mask too. Let me tap the eyeball beside this layer off and on so you can see what this does. It's not a huge difference, but I think that's enough to add some pop into the sky. Next, I'm going to tap on the three little dots icon just to the left of the eyeball. And when this flyout menu appears, I'm going to use the rename command to give this mask a meaningful name. Let's call this one Sky Dehaze. Next, I'm going to tap up here on the Create New Mask button, and then I'm going to choose the Select Sky command again. Lightroom should make the same selection for us that we saw a minute ago, but this time we're going to leave the Dehaze slider alone. On this mask, I'm going to add some warmth using the Temperature and Tint sliders. I'm also going to add a small boost with the Saturation slider. If I turn the eyeball off and on for this layer, then you can see how this one adds some warm yellow into all those clouds. Let's tap on the three little dots icon again at this point, and let's name this one Sky Color. By now, you've probably figured out that we are going to create a separate mask for each attribute, so let's repeat this process. This time, it's a change in the sky brightness that I want to create. To do that, I'll lower the exposure a little bit. I'll also add some contrast, and I'll bring down the highlights, and I'll up the whites just a little. Now, let's rename this mask and call it Sky Brightness. Finally, let's add one more mask, and then I will show you a complete before and after. This time, I want to add 8 units of texture and 5 of clarity. Let's call this one Sky Details. Okay, let me turn this light switch at the top of the masking panel off and on so you can see what we've accomplished with all of these layers. We've gone from this to this, and now the sky really stands out. Building these mask groups was not hard work, but repeating this whole process on sunset after sunset is super tedious. Fortunately, there's a way to automate everything that we have done in this lesson using develop presets here inside of Lightroom Classic. To create a new develop preset, I need to open up the left side panel. Next, I need to open up the presets tab, and then I need to tap on this little plus icon. When this menu appears, I'm going to choose the create new preset option. I know that this big box looks overwhelming, but don't panic. All that we need to do is to tap down here on the check none button at the bottom. Next, tap over here where it says masking, and make sure that all four of the sky mask layers that we just built have little check marks beside them. Now, double check that the new support amount slider option down here near the bottom of this window is active. Finally, come up here to the top where it says preset name, and let's call this one Sunset Warm Boost. I'm also going to click here where it says group, and I'm going to choose my AI mask presets group that I created in a previous tutorial. If you do not have an AI masks group yet, then you could create one at this point, or you could save that step for another day. When everything looks right, tap on the create button, and congratulations, you've just done something amazing. To see the beauty of this kind of develop preset in action, I'm going to slide over to another image. Here we have a photo that is almost identical to the last one, but the clouds have moved around a little bit. Like the last example, I've already cleaned up the overall image, and now I'm ready to make the sky sing. To do that, all I have to do is to tap here on our new Sunset Warm Boost Develop preset. Bam! In no time, Lightroom calculates new masks for me and applies all of those settings that we saved onto each mask group. That was so fast. So let me turn the light switch here at the top of the masking panel off and on a few times so you can see the results again. This is the image without any of those sky masks. And this is it with the masks active again. That was easy. Even better, if I want to make the combined effect of all these masks stronger or weaker, then all I have to do is to drag the preset amount slider over here to the right or to the left. I think that setting this one to about 125 looks even better. But to demo, I'm going to move the preset amount slider all the way up to 200. With the preset amount slider cranked up like this, we are asking Lightroom to double the strength of all the adjustments that we originally saved into this preset. The sky looks pretty overdone now, but I'm doing this to show you one more great feature. In this case, I think what's really making the sky look fake here is the addition of way too much dehaze. So, to solve that problem, I can click in the masking panel on the sky dehaze mask layer. When I'm here, now I can bring the amount slider down for this mask only. That's better, but while I'm in here, I might also click on the sky brightness layer and bring this one down a little bit too. There we go. What I hope you're seeing is that we have the ability to control each attribute, since each one are all in a separate mask layer. Adding this develop preset and a little refinement using the amount sliders has turned this photo from this into this in no time. If you're not impressed yet, then let's slide over to a completely different image from the other side of the national park. Not only is this image from a totally different place, but this one is actually a sunrise where the other two were sunsets. The time of day, the location, they make no difference. It makes no difference. Because as soon as I tap here on the name of our preset, Lightroom Classic goes to work calculating new masks that match this gorgeous scene. Bam, that looks good. And with just a few seconds of work refining the strength of each individual layer, I think I can make things look even better. Okay, now we're cooking. We've gone from this to this in under a minute. This is truly mind-blowing stuff, but before we move on, I do need to warn you that AI adaptive presets like these are not going to work perfectly for you every time. These develop presets are only going to work well on images where Lightroom's Detect Sky Masking algorithm produces very high quality results, on images where the algorithm only selects part of the sky, or when it accidentally includes things that don't belong in these masks, then you'll need to slow down and refine the mask using some other technique. But when the AI engine works as expected, and it usually works pretty well, then this type of develop preset is a tremendous time saver for the busy landscape photographer. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.